First off, we're going to start here with a very unique coin. Now, this is a state quarter. It's what, you know, looks like, you know, kind of a normal state quarter, but it sold for over $2,800. So $2,800, and here's why. And it's important that I kind of go a little in depth on this coin and explain it, because a lot of people ask questions about these types of coins. Now, this coin here was struck on what is called an experimental planchet. So it is a very rare coin. It's not struck on what a normal quarter is supposed to be struck on. So the planchet is basically the coin itself without the design. So before the design is struck on it by the die is what strikes it. Now here's an example of what a die looks like that strikes coins. So this is the half dollar die. So it has the design, it comes down, it stamps the planchet. I hope that kind of explains that better. But a lot of people get these quarters confused with quarters like this. So these are coins that are sold on some, you know, coin collecting websites, and this is an example of what is called gold-plated coins. See, they only sell for $4 or $5, not valuable. They're just regular state quarters that are plated. So those kind of get mistaken for error coins. Now, a good way to test if you have a coin struck on an experimental planchet or even struck on a foreign planchet would be to weigh the coin. So the regular quarter should weigh around 5.67 grams. That's what, you know, a regular quarter should weigh. Now, silver quarters weigh more, of course. They weigh around 6.25 grams. So you can always weigh your coins to determine if your coin was struck on a silver planchet as well. But let's get back to this experimental planchet. Now, what is that exactly? Now, basically what happened in 1999, as we know, the Sacagawea dollar comes out in the year 2000, but those dies that struck the coin were unavailable at the time. So the alloy of the Sacagawea dollar, because they couldn't test the design of the Sacagawea dollar, the alloy, the metal that they used for it, was used, tested on the state quarter dies. And that is what we see here with this quarter. So a Sacagawea alloy, the metal being tested with the design of the quarter. So hopefully that kind of explains the situation there. So $2,800 for that coin. Next up are two amazing Lincoln cents that sold for some pretty good money. So these two pennies here sold for over $1,600. And we see here on the left that one has been double struck and it's off center. And then here on the right, we have an indent from that first coin and they are a mated pair together. So really, really unique coins here. Of course, finding something like this in a coin roll is gonna be very, very tough. But these coins did sell for over $1,600, so not too bad. Speaking of Sacagawea dollars, now here is a 2000 Sacagawea dollar that was struck 15 times. So this is definitely not damaged. You see the design there being struck twice. You see Liberty twice. Really, really awesome error coin here. And this dollar coin sold for over $3,000. To be exact, it sold for over $3,300. So still a $3,000 coin for $1. Now here's a type of error that you could look for on, you know, a lot of different coins. It is a 1999, but it's not only off center, it's also double struck. So we see the design twice there, you see the date 1999 twice. Really, really awesome error. Would love to find something like this in a coin roll, man. That would be amazing. Don't need a coin microscope for anything like this. You would definitely be able to see it like right away. And this penny sold for over $1,100. So a $1,000 penny right there. Kind of the same thing with this coin. It's been multi-struck. It's a 1993 Kennedy half dollar. The coin sold for over $2,500. So always, you know, check your change, go to the bank, get rolls of coins, search through them. You know, you never know what you're gonna find. It's all luck when it comes down to it. Let's move on to a 1996 Roosevelt dime. Now this coin has been double struck on a 1995. So we got a 1996 dime on a 1995 dime. So really unique error. Can't really tell from a distance, you know, looking at this coin. So you gotta get real close up and use that coin microscope to your advantage. This coin here sold for over $2,000. Now this next coin here is a 1998 Washington quarter. We see here on the front, it looks perfectly normal, But here on the reverse is where we see that error taking place. And this is an indent error. It was actually indented by a 1 cent planchet, so a penny coin. And this quarter sold for over $1,200. $1,000 quarter there. Moving on to a 1998 Jefferson nickel. Now this coin is awesome. It's been struck 100 times. 100 times, can you believe that? That is just an amazing looking nickel there. Would love to come across something like that. This nickel sold for over $2,000. Now here is a 2008 presidential dollar coin. Now I've talked about these in the past. It is missing the edge lettering. On the edge of the coin there's lettering, it's missing it, but it's also a die adjustment strike. So we see that the design is faded out all around the rim of the coin there. So that's gonna give the coin some value. We see that here on the reverse as well, and this dollar coin sold for over $1,300. Again, turning a dollar into over $1,000. Now here is a 1999 state quarter. Now this is a mated pair here again, and we got the indent error taking place, partial collar. So really awesome type of error coins here. Man, that is just amazing. I'm not sure if these actually get out or, you know, if this is directly from the mint, but these coins did sell together for over $2,400. This next coin here is a 1999 state quarter. Now you can look for cap dies on, you know, just about any type of coinage really, but this is a reverse cap die taking place on that New Jersey state quarter. And we can see that this error is a very noticeable type of error. It's pretty extreme. And this coin here sold for over $2,000 as a result of that mint error. All right, guys, don't forget to subscribe in the middle. Check out the videos to the left of me. And until tomorrow, I'll see you all in the comment section below. This is Couch Collectibles, and this is where I disappear.